Now let us try to understand how to add users and assign privileges. To do this, launch PowerSchema Studio and click on the security icon. Now click on the Roles tab. Roles define a set of permissions that can be assigned to users of the same type. Before you create a role, determine the permissions required by the users that will be assigned to the role based on the available privileges and areas. The Citex SCADA provides 8 privileges, numbered 1 to 8, that you can use to restrict access to some of the elements in a runtime system. These elements can include graphic pages, graphic page objects, alarms, trends, SPC tags, accumulators, keyboard commands, and reports. These privilege levels, the numbers 1 to 8, are defined for the desktop client. The web client has a different set of privilege levels, which are again mapped to the Citex privilege levels, which will be discussed later in the web client chapter. Now, to add a new role, you can enter the name of the role. For example, I'm entering an admin role. I'm going to assign him privileges 1 to 8. I will set allow RPC to true. Allow RPC, setting allow RPC to true will enable remote procedure calls. I'll set allow EXEC to false and manage users to false because these are not required for the moment. Once you have entered in all the required information for creating a new role, please click on save to save the changes. You can also assign a Windows group and map that particular group to a role. For example, if I have a Windows group titled Operators, I have mapped it to the admin role. By doing this, all the users in the Operators Windows group will have the admin role access. As usual, when you enter something or when you modify something, please click on Save to save the changes. Now let's add a user. Every user that you add needs to be assigned to a role to be granted privileges and access to areas. Now let's create a username called admin. Give it a password. In my case, my password is also admin. Click on OK. Here, from the drop-down, choose the new role called admin that we have created just now. Once you have entered all the details in the new row, please click on save to save the changes. Now we have created a new role called admin. We have mapped the Windows group operators, which means all the users in this particular Windows group will have the admin access. We have given it an access level or the privilege levels of 1 to 8. And we have also created a new user called admin and mapped it to a role admin which we have just created. That's how we create roles and users.